Hello and welcome to today's Daily Market Update with me, Joshua Mahoney, Research Analyst here at Alpari UK. Global indices are pulling back a little bit, pairing some of the gains that we have seen that pushed the likes of the S&P to record highs on Monday. Yesterday we saw some indecision and now we're seeing some pulling back in the likes of the European equities and also pushing across to the futures market in the US as well. It seems like the same kind of thing's going on. A lot of this really is in line with the fact that we're coming towards the business end of the week with the likes of the ECB monetary policy decision tomorrow, also the jobs report on Friday, and today we have had the services PMI figure out of the UK, which is the most important of the three PMI figures out of the UK, along with the ADP figure later today out of the US. Now, firstly, overnight we did hear from Australia in terms of their GDP figure. Both the quarter-on-quarter figure and the year-on-year figure were both better than expected. We saw 3.5 on a year-on-year basis, which is pretty reasonable growth, really. It's, you know, considering the fact that people are looking towards the Australian region and thinking that we're seeing significant weaknesses within it. It's just another sign to show that, in actual fact, throughout this whole weakening of the Chinese region, the Australian economy has actually done quite well, and this essentially hammers that home. Now, given the fact that we have seen these figures coming out of China in terms of improved manufacturing PMI figures, non-manufacturing PMI figures, and that HSBC manufacturing figure is also approaching 50. It seems as if the slowdown in China is actually coming to an end, just at a time when we're getting these really strong figures coming out of Australia that shows that even with a weakening China, they're still faring very well. So very strong signs for the Australian economy. We've seen a bit of strength in the Australian dollar off the back of that. And in terms of the outlook for the region, really we are expecting it to pick up and push on from here, really. Iron ore prices have fed into that increased GDP level because of the fact that we're seeing prices hold up, but also demand hold up from the Chinese region, and export market is actually thriving at a period where we thought they might actually have some weaknesses. So very good out of the Australian economy. Now today in the European session, really the main focus was upon the UK services PMI figure, the third PMI of the week. Firstly, we got the manufacturing figure, disappointed and fell. Then we got the construction PMI figure, again, disappointed and fell. And today, we were hoping that we weren't going to see a third disappointment in terms of the services PMI figure. Now, in actual fact, it did beat estimates, although it did fall somewhat. It only fell by 0.1, so it was a very marginal drop, and potentially this means that it's somewhat on a plateau and maybe we're going to start pushing towards the upside. I guess positives can be taken that the expectations was for it to fall, and it didn't fall quite as much. But I do want to see this start moving towards the upside. The UK economy is majorly dependent on the services sector for around about 70 to 80% of its GDP growth. And so if we have a weakening or a slowing of the growth in the services sector, then that's really going to have an impact on the GDP figure going forward. So hopefully in next month's figure, we'll actually see this manage to rise towards the upside. But it was good that we actually saw the most important of the three figures actually not disappoint. So that was a positive thing. Now, in terms of the rest of the day, everyone's really looking towards that ADP non-farm payroll figure. Friday's non-farm payroll figure is the main event, really. But today's figure is a sort of proxy for Friday's release. Now, the correlation between the two is tenuous at best. Sometimes you'll see them actually move together. Sometimes they'll move in complete opposite directions. So in terms of using today's figure as a gauge for what we're going to see on Friday, I don't think it necessarily holds that much value. But in terms of its own merit as a headline employment figure, I think it's well worth watching out for. And if we saw any major miss to the upside or to the downside, then there is a potential to see a bit of volatility coming into the markets. Tomorrow, bear in mind that we are expecting to see potentially the most, biggest thing that's going to happen this week in terms of the ECB decision from Mario Draghi. And then on Friday, we're going to be seeing that jobs report, which always is the big thing to watch out for every month. So we have got an action-packed end to the week to watch out for. Also, tomorrow we do have a webinar that you can sign up for that is for the live ECB release, so you can be with us and we'll take you through some charts for when the release happens and just after it to see the actual response that we've seen in the markets. So that's it for today, guys. If you want any more news and analysis, come check out the Alpari newsroom at alpari.co.uk/newsroom or check me out on Twitter. My name's Joshua Mahoney, research analyst here at Alpari UK. Have a great day.